Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the adrenocorticotropic hormone, ACTH. Adrenocorticotropic hormone is an important hormone that controls growth and secretion of adrenal cortex. It mainly influences the secretion of cortisol. ACTH plays a vital role in physiology of stress and pathophysiology of stress disorders. It influences the secretion of which one? Cortisol. Okay. Source and structure. Adrenocorticotropic hormone is secreted from the corticotropes of anterior pituitary. That constitutes 10 to 20% of its total cell population. How much percent? 10 to 20%. ACTH is the smallest peptide hormone of anterior pituitary, containing the 39 amino acids. Which one is the smallest peptide of anterior pituitary? That is adrenocorticotropic hormones. With how many amino acids? 39. Okay. What is the molecular weight of adrenocorticotropic hormone? It is 4500, that is 4500 daltons. Coming to the synthesis. Like other peptide hormones, ACTH is synthesized as a pre-pro hormone. How it synthesized? Firstly, as a pre-pro hormone, it is synthesized in the corticotropes as a part of large molecule called pro-opium melanocortin. How it synthesized? In corticotropes. In which form? Pro-opium melanocortin. Okay. It cleaves to form the beta lipotropin and adrenocorticotropic hormone. Pro-opium melanocortin is cleaves to form which ones? Beta lipotropin and adrenocorticotropic hormone. In human beings, pro-opium melanocortin cleaves to form beta lipoprotein as well as adrenocorticotropic hormone in human beings. In other species, pro-opium melanocortin also forms beta endorphins. Okay, in other species, it also forms beta endorphins. In the intermediate lobe of pituitary, pro-opium melanocortin forms alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone. Okay, melanocyte is different with melanin. In intermediate lobe of pituitary, it forms the melanocyte. Okay, melanocyte stimulating hormone, alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone, especially in lower vertebrates, intervertebrate. Intermediate lobe is rudimentary in humans. However, in humans, adrenocorticotropic hormone contains alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone sequence at its N-terminal, and therefore it processes intrinsic alpha melanocyte stimulating activity at which terminal? In humans, adrenocorticotropic hormone contains alpha melanocyte stimulating hormone at N-terminal. Okay, so it possesses which activity? Intrinsic alpha melanocyte stimulating activity. Okay. Coming to circadian rhythm of adrenocorticotropic secretion, hormone secretion. Normally, adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion occurs in irregular bursts. Okay, irregularly it secretion occurs. The pulsatile secretion of adrenocorticotropic hormone is due to several bursts of corticotropic releasing hormone secretion in 24 hours. However, there is a prominent diurnal rhythm for adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, okay, in which secretion is more in the early morning, which constitutes about 75% of total 24-hour secretion, at which time in the 24 hours adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion is more, and how much percent? At early morning secretion is more, and 75% of total 24-hour secretion is occurred. Okay, the secretion begins to rise at about 4 a.m. and reach a peak between 7 and 8 a.m. and then falls slowly to basal level by noon. Okay, it begins to rise at 4 a.m. and reach peak stage between the 7 and 10 a.m. okay, after then it level falls by noon. Okay, small peak occurs in the evening between the 4 and 6 p.m. at peak level, at highest peak at 7 to 10 a.m. small peak occurs at evening 4 to 6 p.m. highest peak at morning, lowest peak at the evening, but the rise in this peak occurs at 4 a.m. Secretion is minimal when the person sleeps, especially in the midnight when the individual is in the deep sleep. Again, adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion starts increasing at about 2 hours after awakening. Secretion is minimal when person is in deep sleep, okay, especially at midnight we say. After 2 hours of waking up, its secretion starts increasing. This diurnal variation in adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion is due to the natural sleep-wake cycle controlled by inherent biological rhythm of suprachiasmatic nucleus of hypothalamus. The diurnal variation in adrenocorticotropic hormone is controlled by which one? It is controlled by inherent biological rhythm of suprachiasmatic nucleus of hypothalamus. Which nucleus controls the diurnal variation in adrenocorticotropic hormone? It is suprachiasmatic nucleus of hypothalamus. Suprachiasmatic nucleus of hypothalamus. The pattern of secretion is reversed in individuals who sleep in the day and remain awake in the during night. The pattern of glucocorticoid secretion closely follows the adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. Okay. Regulation of adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. Regulation. We are talking about adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion from anterior pituitary is controlled by various factors. However, the primary factor controlling adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion is corticotropin releasing hormone secreted from hypothalamus. Many factors influence adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion by regulating corticotropin releasing hormone secretion from hypothalamus. Corticotropin releasing hormone, in addition to its stimulation of adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, also stimulates sympathetic activity, increases blood pressure, and activates brainstem reticular activating system, causes arousal. Also, antidiuretic hormone is an important regulator of adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. Which one is the primary factor that controls the adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion? That is corticotropin releasing hormone. There is many factors that regulate the corticotropin releasing hormone secretion from hypothalamus, and it also influences the adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. In addition to this, corticotropin releasing hormone has some other functions like stimulation. Other than stimulation of adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, it also stimulates the sympathetic activity. That means it increases the blood pressure and activates brain stem reticular activating system, becomes arousal. It's wake up the man. And along with corticotropin releasing hormone, antidiuretic hormone is also important regulator of adrenocorticotropic hormone. Factors that increase adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. Corticotropin releasing hormone, antidiuretic hormone, sleep-wake transition, stress, hypoglycemia, surgery, anesthesia, injury, infection, fever, anxiety, depression, alpha receptor agonist, alpha receptor agonist, beta receptor antagonist, alpha agonist, beta antagonist, okay, the above the receptors, and serotonin, acetylcholine, interleukins, and gastrointestinal hormones, and this increase the secretion of adrenocorticotropic hormone. Factors that inhibit adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion are, what are the factors that inhibit adrenocorticotropic secretions? These are cortisol, adrenocorticotropic hormone, somatostatin, GABA, brain natriuretic peptide, and opioids. Once again, the factors that inhibit adrenocorticotropic hormone are cortisol, adrenocorticotropic hormone, somatostatin, GABA, brain natriuretic peptide, and opioids. Okay, adrenocorticotropic hormone and stress. Stress and hypothalamo-pituitary adrenocortical axis are closely associated. Stress profoundly influences this neuroendocrine axis. Which neuroendocrine axis? Hypothalamus. It is neuropituitary. It is endocrine adrenocortico axis. Because we are talking about the adrenocorticotropic hormone. Okay. Once again, neuroendocrine axis is nothing but here. About neuron is hypothalamus. Okay, hypothalamo is the neuron, and endocrine means it is about, we are talking about the pituitary. It is endocrine axis is, we are talking about the adrenocortico axis. Okay, this is the axis. Stress profoundly influences this neuroendocrine axis. Increased adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion is an immediate response of the body to any form of stress. Therefore, stress is defined as a condition that results in increased adrenocorticotropic hormone level in plasma. If we feel stress or fear in any anxiety, our adrenocorticotropic hormone level in plasma is raised or increased. Due to increased adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, glucocorticoid secretion increases rapidly. In spite of increased cortisol secretion, adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion continues to remain high due to direct stimulation of hypothalamo-pituitary adrenocortical axis by neurally mediated stimulation of hypothalamic paraventricular nucleus that secretes corticotropin releasing hormone. Once again, I am explaining this. Due to increased adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, if there is increase in adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion, glucocorticoid secretion increases rapidly. This causes the glucocorticoid secretion increases rapidly. In spite of increased cortisol secretion, adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion continues to remain high due to direct stimulation of hypothalamo-pituitary-adrenocortical axis by neurally mediated stimulation of hypothalamic paraventricular nucleus that secretes corticotropin releasing hormone. Neurally it mediated stimulation of which one? Hypothalamo paraventricular nucleus, okay, that which secretes the corticotropin releasing hormone. In stress, higher brain center stimulates the hypothalamic nucleus to secrete corticotropin releasing hormone at a high rate. The stress induce corticotropin releasing hormone release overrides the negative feedback control of adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. If stress continues, glucocorticoid concentration remains high and mechanism of negative feedback controls operates at a higher set point. Okay, mechanism of action. Adrenocorticotropic hormone acts primarily by increasing cyclic AMP in the target cells. How it primarily acts? By increasing cyclic AMP in the target cells. What are the functions? Adrenocorticotropic hormone stimulates synthesis and secretion of cortisol and other steroid hormones from adrenal cortex by stimulating growth of specific zone of adrenal cortex. Adrenal corticotropic hormone increases adrenocortical secretion by producing hypertrophy rather than hyperplasia of adrenal cells. It increases in size rather than function of adrenal cells. The impact of adrenocorticotropic hormone is main on glucocorticoid secretion rather on other steroids. Adrenocorticotropic hormone has intrinsic MSH melanocyte stimulating hormone activity. Therefore, it stimulates growth and activity of melanocytes. This results in hyperpigmentation of skin due to the increase in synthesis of melanin. Okay, thus its action on hyperpigmentation of skin. The factors for, okay, don't stress, okay, if you got stress you become so dark. Okay guys, be cool. The receptors for adrenocorticotropic hormone are also present in the gastrointestinal tract and brain, where it also acts as a local neurotransmitter. Adrenocorticotropic hormone influences immunity by controlling secretion of cytokines from lymphocytes. Cytokines also stimulate adrenocorticotropic hormone secretion. Hypothalamus when in stressful stimuli or any sleep-wake transition, and when the hormones that acts like norepinephrine, acetylcholine, 5-hydroxythyrosine, this acts on hypothalamus It causes the release of antidiuretic hormone and corticotropin releasing hormone. It acts on, it stimulates the anterior pituitary corticotropes for the release of adrenocorticotropic hormone. And this adrenocorticotropic hormone acts on the adrenal cortex for the release of cortisol. This cortisol acts negatively on anterior pituitary, particularly on corticotropins. This means this is a negative feedback effect, and this adrenocorticotropic hormone also has negative feedback effect on hypothalamus. Thus, the secretion of adrenocorticotropic hormone is regulated. Okay. In this video, we find a thing that when we feel stress, our body skin become more dark. Okay. Because adrenocorticotropic hormone has intrinsic melanocyte stimulating hormones that increases the melanin, which causes hyperpigmentation of our skin and becomes we dark. So guys, be cool. Okay, thank you for watching. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. And our next topic is luteinizing hormone and follicular stimulating hormone. Okay, thank you.